Threadripper CPUs. Do you even still need them? I mean, the Ryzen 95950X, which is a consumer CPU, already has 16 cores and 32 threads. Why would you even still need such a big boy like this? That's what she said. But what if you need more juice for 3D work, or even if your butt itchy want to edit 8K footage? Not speaking from experience. Today, we are going to review and find out if this AMD Ryzen Threadripper 3960X with 24 cores and 48 threads is still worth buying in 2021. Let's get ripping. Correct, ma? Threadripper, rip mo? Walao eh, RIP writer. So I've recently switched to the Ryzen 95950X from my older 2nd generation Threadripper CPU, which is the 2950X, mainly because of the single core performance boosts, since I need to game for research purposes. And also PCIe 4.0 support, mainly for the faster storage speeds. But being a PC enthusiast like myself, who is used to being on a higher end platform, because I am higher end, the 5950X is barely able to scratch my itch for PC Master Race supremacy, because it only has 4 slots of RAM on the X570 motherboard, while I'm used to having 8. The more the merrier, ma. That's what they said. They didn't say it, I say. So let's address the elephant in the room, which is the Ryzen Threadripper 3960X, which is quite big lah, just like your X. The Threadripper 3960X is built on the Zen 2 architecture. It has 4 Zen 2 7nm chiplets paired with a single central I/O die via an improved Infinity Fabric interconnect, with each chiplets having 6 cores respectively for a total of 24 cores and 48 threads. It has a base clock of 3.8GHz and 4.5GHz boost. Compared to previous generations, all 4 chiplets can now simultaneously access all the memory and I/O, which will boost performance across the board, especially when it comes to single core performance, which has been the biggest weakness of Threadripper CPUs. As an upgrade from the previous generation, the 3960X now supports PCIe Gen 4 and 4 memory lanes up to DDR4 3200MHz compared to the 2933MHz of the last gen. So the previous generation Threadripper processors had to choose between uniform and non-uniform memory access, but this new 3rd generation Threadripper essentially acts as a single NUMA node by default, which means that you're gonna see no performance differences across the board in most circumstances. What this means for you is that you can hop into your game and play a few hours, hop back out and do some serious 3D work or video editing, and not see any sort of performance dip. A much more seamless computing experience. The only drawback is now my X399 motherboard with its TR4 socket is now obsolete. Although it looks almost identical to the new STRX4 socket and the TRX40 chipset that this CPU was built for. This is because while both sockets have the same 4096 pins, AMD has changed some of the functions on some of the pins to improve trace pathing towards a more stable platform for PCIe 4.0 and future CPUs. The new TRX40 chipset includes 16 usable PCIe Gen 4 lanes through a double wide 8 lane link to the CPU, which means that we can now get 4 times the link speed than the previous generation, and the total number of usable PCIe Express lanes jumps from 60 to 72. Considering that most devices are still using PCIe 3.0, even if you use up all the PCIe lanes provided by this TRX40 chipset, for instance, if you have multiple M.2 SSDs, or if you are very geng chao and can find multiple RTX 3090s during this shortage and put them in SLI, you will never run into a bottleneck. Just like how I never run into a bottleneck with my wallet or my 25,000 square feet mansion, because I'm the bangsawan. Now let's take a look at some numbers. Firstly, we have synthetic benchmarks. Next, we have real-world benchmarks based on 3D and video editing software. We'll be right back. while I know that gaming is not relevant at all with the Threadripper processor, in case you are someone like me who wants to work hard and play harder, here are some gaming benchmarks. I know, a 2970WX would have made a better comparison because it has the same cores and thread count, but we didn't have one. We only have the 2950X, so there's that. And while some benchmarks that utilize multi-threading a lot better will actually benefit from the extra cores from the 2970WX, the single core performance should still be quite consistent across the board, so our numbers are still quite valid. But what we were more interested to find out is in which ways is the 3960X better than the consumer Ryzen 9 5950X. So in conclusion, if you want a processor only for gaming, go for the consumer CPUs. If you want to do video editing, mostly for YouTube and also social media, then also stick to the consumer CPUs. If you want extra juice, and for 3D animation or like very heavy video editing work, or if you need all the extra connectivity options that come with the TRX40 chipset as well as a Threadripper CPU, then go for Threadripper. If you're coming from the previous generation Threadripper CPUs, it depends. If you need PCIe Gen 4 for faster storage as well, as this is actually very important, the faster memory support, memory speed support, then it makes sense for you to upgrade. For me, it actually does, because I feel that the faster memory speed as well as the faster PCIe Gen 4 storage will actually help for certain workloads that we do here at Mob House. Also, I want a little bit more future-proofing in case PCIe Gen 4 GPUs start rolling out in the future, and I don't want to upgrade my motherboard again, so yeah. I'm probably gonna get one. So I give this Ryzen Threadripper 3960X a very commendable 8 out of 10. I would have scored it a little bit higher if it launched at the same price as the previous generation 2970WX, but it is what it is. It is still a very niche processor for a very specific consumer, maybe like myself, who work more than I game. If you thought this video is awesome, you know what to do. Leave a comment down below if you have any questions regarding this processor or Threadripper processors in general, or if you want us to actually do more videos specifically about Threadripper processors, that would be great as well. We will also try to reply to your comments in our comment section after our videos, so there's that. Don't forget to follow us on Facebook and Instagram to see more shenanigans from the Mob House crew, and I will see you in the next one. Keep on ripping. This is not muscle, it's just fat in disguise. Times for the comment session, and today we're gonna reply to some comments from our previous Ryzen 5 3600 content creator PC. The first comment comes from Fizzly. He doesn't really like our poetry and unboxing videos, and he actually likes this one. Hello, come lah bro. Everybody have different tastes. I like petai and jering. Maybe you don't like leh. Huh. Why can't we just love to respect each other? It's taste. License and registration show says, loving the channel, currently building a new PC for editing, and you make hunting down parts less boring. Gonna need some of that bangsawan gear over here in the US. Well, the US YouTubers are actually the OG here. I'm just the, you know, the secondary people. But I would love to send some bangsawanness to you in the US of A. Simian say, I have a similar build, though I have a 3070. Wow bro, you trying to throw me now, is it? Huh? Now GPU shortage and you shove the 3070 in my face? Good on you. Moving to the mystical world of Facebook. Okay. Firstly, I want to shout out to the 5 people who were eating while watching this video on Facebook. Gang bullet! Jeff Johnson say, Aya, don't be like that lah with the beza. Hey bro, I said ma, it ain't pretty but it will get the job done, right? But jokes aside, I think that the beza is actually a very good budget option of a car in the wonderful world of Chuti Chuti Malaysia. Huh, throw you only, where can Chuti? Myvan Place say, so how much is the total cost of that build? And the last comment I'm going to read comes from Arif Ali. Pump face, I buy the R5 3500 yesterday. Today I watched this content, GG. That's why you should always subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on anything. Happy or not? You click already? Why? Sound like ice cream truck, right? Ting ting! Mat ku, selalu.